Gerald W. Brister, let's continue with our questions and answers. I had a young man, bead hand. He just started running beads predominantly, so he must be doing pretty good. And he asked me some questions about the old school running beads. And there's some differences, but I think it's probably very similar still. I watched a young man the other day on somebody's video, and he was doing everything pretty much right. And when you run beads, there's a couple of things you want to do. This is a recommendation, nothing written in stone. But I never liked the auto lenses to run beads because you can get down when a bead's soaking or it's getting hard to get in, and that'll shut the light off and your lens will flicker and it'll pop back in your eyes. So I like a fixed lens, particularly when I'm running beads. I like a number 8. Or I say beads, root to you guys. I'm sorry, I forget. I'm so used to my own colloquial pipeline lingo. So you're running the roots, you're running the beads. And I want a number 8 fixed, and the only reason is because they don't make a 7. The fire when you're running a root is inside the pipe. You don't really have any fire outside, so you don't need a real dark lens, okay? What you do need is to be able to see that space in front of you. I should be anticipating the space. I should be seeing it getting tighter, so I know I'm going to be going up ahead of time instead of waiting until I'm in trouble to holler out. I may know that it's getting too wide. I need to go down. So you want a number 8 fixed lens, like dark sunglasses kind of, and you can see what's going on. The other thing is, I got a job one time. A welder foreman was testing several welders, and I got put running beads because of how I tested. He was an old school guy, and he knew what a bead hand should be doing. And the main thing is, when you start off on top, you should take 2 fingers with that rod to stabilize it. You can hold it different ways, get it started, and that rod should be pretty much 90 degrees as you come off the top. And then as you come down, you can start dropping your hand and rolling with it. A lot of people are a little bit lazy. We don't want to have that shoulder up like that. And so they will take that rod, and they're putting it sort of straight up at a 90. They got it laid like this. And that can make you have a blowout there. You can make it gut it a little bit if you're running too hot. So the other thing is that you want to wear cotton gloves if you're not having a hot pass. I used to wear cotton gloves or TIG gloves because when you're running that bead fast and hot, it's a very light touch. You don't want to be all clumsy with those firing line and filling capping gloves. So get you some TIG gloves or some cotton gloves and you can feel that thing ever so slightly. I'm Gerald W. Brister, and that's your bead hand tips for today.